There's a very minority that actually on the deen.
Yeah.
And the one that on the deen, they're being pressured by everyone else who are not. Subhanallah. You're weird, you're abnormal, they're getting bullied.
Following the massive success of our Lost tour, we now present Lost 2, Solutions to the Muslim Youth Crisis.
So from my experience, like 20-30% of my friends were atheists who were originally Muslims. So, but I think it's happening more and more and more.
For a whole generation, we've been asleep behind the wheel, whilst our youth have been suffering from a lack of support and services with no real voice in the community.
I see Muslims who are going out, maybe they wear a scarf and to them that's modesty.
Okay.
But then they're going out with boys, they're smoking, they're drinking, they're doing this, they're doing that, they're lying.
Alarming lifestyle trends and double lives are commonplace amongst the majority of Muslim youth.
The person, like nearly I know, more over 75% of them have taken drugs or have girlfriends.
Muslims.
Yeah, Muslims.
Yeah.
Yet our communities remain in a state of denial or just simply unaware. At Lost 2, we will be offering real-world solutions on parenting, mental health, marriage, aspirations, role models, attitudes and behaviours, identity and so much more.
Personally, I can't think of one person, like right now on top of my head, I can't think of one person that hasn't been in some sort of situation with a girl or a boy.
Don't miss out on this night of inspiration, turning lost into hope and a bright future for your children.
No, there's never balance. It's always too strict that it causes fear that they can't talk or they're too loose that, you know, they don't have that kind of relationship with the parents that they can speak to them by.
Okay, what would work? What would work?
Sit me down.
Sit
talk
down.
To me, talk man. To talk to me.
Okay.
Communication, love.
Book your session now at drdeen.com.